This is at a, again a very high level, and we already talked about the tailoring guidance that is provided by NIST with respect to 853. So you take all those security control, catalog of control that are listed in there, and then you determine whether you need to be in the low or moderate or high impact category. And even they have another category called enhanced security. So you determine which category you need to be under. And then like for each one of those categories, they have the list of security control that they require us to implement, right? So essentially the guidance is provided right here. First identify and designate those controls. And then I determine the scope of the system that you need to have all these things in place. If you are not able to implement some of those controls that are provided there, then what kind of compensating controls you have in place, right? Those are like some of the questions. And then again, there is a concept called parameter values, like whether the particular control is applicable across the board or just within a subset of the entire systems and stuff. So those are like some of those things that will be kind of tailored according to your setup, according to your organization information systems. Right. Then use that. And then once that is tailored, and then essentially what you're going to be doing is you're going to be documenting all this security control decision, why you're choosing this, and what is the impact, and then why and how does that what is the rationale behind all those things, right, in terms of why you're picking low or moderate or high, and then why you're deciding to restrict some of the system in like kind of a subsystem and stuff. That's essentially is what the 853 implementation is all about, right? So making sure that like you have this identify this, document all those things in terms of the reasoning and the rationale behind it, and then implement those things, right? So this is at a very high level. I think there are close to about 18 or so families within 853. So starting from access control all the way to program management. As you could see here, each of those families are identified with a two-letter ID, right? Is access control is AC, and somebody is referring, hey, okay, so you implemented AC5, AC-5 in 853. That's what they're talking about. So they're talking about the specific access control for item number 5 that is listed in 853. That's what they're talking about. So there are close to about 290 or so controls in 853. That's pretty much the total controls that have been developed by NIST. Again, like depending on your tailoring guidance that you are using, you will come up with your own implementation details, and you might probably implement only subset of it, right? So out of 290 plus, you will probably be implementing about 100 or 150 controls and stuff. So that's the way it works. I will probably give you a second to go over each one of those families. That kind of helps you, if you are going to go over the families individually, that kind of helps you to think through the different areas that 853 focuses. So this is all not listed based on the priority. It's a general requirement, but again, the prioritization is something that is covered as part of, I'm gonna cover that in a second, yeah. So if you see the mechanics of it, so if you see, for example, the AC1 that we talked about, access control policies and procedure, do you first of all have those access control policies and procedure? So it's considered as P1 here. So what essentially it means is it's a priority one. So priority one controls takes precedence versus priority two versus priority three, right? The same way. So priority, of course, they do have P0 as well. So that is not prioritized, and you could essentially choose, right? So and then depending on whether you are trying to implement low impact, moderate impact, or high impact, you are going to implement AC. In this case, AC1 is required for all these three different areas. Whereas if you're looking at account management, so within account management, only AC2 is required for low impact, and AC2, 1, 2, 3, and 4 is all required for moderate impact. And as you could see, like, you know, depending on, you know, what kind of baseline that you want to use, and your control, number of control that you want to implement in your area is going to go up, right? So generally the high impact controls baseline is going to have more controls to be implemented versus a low impact one, right? And then also like uses priority in terms of coming up with your remediation plans and other things, or project management and things, so that like you can accordingly implement the right controls and use kind of 80-20 rule to address the most important risk versus the least important risk, right? So I think we talked about this one briefly in terms of low impact, moderate impact, and high impact. As I said, like there is another category, which is enhanced security assurance as well. So organization who want to implement you know, full control of 853, which is the topmost level, then you can actually choose enhanced security assurance, right? So this is an example for low assurance requirement. Right, if you see here, low assurance has only these many requirements that needs to be implemented in their area, right? And then each of the controls are listed something like this. So I just got a screenshot of one of these requirements. So as you could see, is access control policy and procedure, which is kind of a mandatory requirement for all this low impact, medium impact, and high impact, right? So it talks about where does this control falls into play? It is the organization, or it is just the security, or it is other areas. And then also we have a control description, right? Develop, document, and disseminate. Here in this particular case, assignment is organization defined personnel or roles. So you could essentially develop this access control policy and procedure for the entire organization, or just for a subset of the groups within your organization. So that is why they specifically call out the assignment, right? And then, or like it could be based on the role also, right? And then, so they talk in detail about what does it contains. It contains the purpose, scope, roles, and responsibility, and the management's commitment to all those things. And then also they talk about having these procedures to facilitate this implementation and thing. So they also talk about reviewing and updating this current one, how frequently you need to be updating it, whether it needs to be updated. So assignment is something that you come up with your own assignment. So it could be 1 year, or it could be 6 months, every 6 months or something like that. And then the procedures again, you know, what is, how frequently you update those things, right? And then they also have supplemental guidance, you know, like if you are really specific about implementing this one across the board, or like if you need some additional guidance with respect to this particular implementation, you could go, you could get some additional guidance from this area, supplemental guidance area, and then decide like how you want to be implementing that particular control, right? And then the control enhancement. So the one thing good, one good thing about 853 is they continuously update this one. And let's say like if there are some new procedure or new policy that needs to be defined, now that like a lot of people are accessing their enterprise applications using the mobile system, so they would even introduce certain things as part of their control enhancement, which will be published towards in the different section. Or if it is the control assessment for this particular area is required, then like they will update it here, right? And also they have their references in terms of, you know, where else it kind of maps to this particular access control policy and procedure. And then the priority and baseline allocation, I think like we talked about it already, P1 is high level priority. And then like, you know, this is AC1 is required for all this.
For more information, click on the link below or visit databrackets.com.